Two high school girls were chatting happily in the schoolyard. Suddenly, the girl with long white hair and headphones excitedly said to her friend with short hair, "Look over there! That's the genius of our academy. I heard he has already completed the entire advanced professional curriculum." The girl with short hair turned to look, drawn by the handsome appearance of the main character. They excitedly expressed that they would definitely confess to him one day. He's the most amazing person in school. Now that he's been promoted, his profession will be incredibly powerful, they said. He's truly perfect and unmatched by anyone. In our advanced society today, everyone looks up to those who are called geniuses. The story begins 100 years ago when the world was invaded by a game. Countless types of monsters appeared, and humans gradually awakened their skills. Humanity's fate was to fight monsters and level up after job changes. If not, their end was simply death. In contrast, geniuses became the center of attention, sought after by everyone. Their abilities determined humanity's fate. The main character of this story is Jiang Li, who traveled to this world 18 years ago. Thanks to his exceptional talent, he worked hard to learn many different abilities. He had been waiting for this unique moment for a long time. His goal was clear: to become the absolute strongest. His records clearly stated that all his combat skills, from warrior, mage, and assassin to advanced classes, were rated as excellent. Most professions varied in strength and difficulty of awakening, especially the hidden ones. It's not an exaggeration to say 1 in 10,000 can awaken, and when they do, they possess incredibly terrifying power. Even the selectors were amazed, confident that he could awaken a hidden profession. His future was limitless, and the selectors had never been wrong about judging people. When someone is too outstanding, envy and jealousy from others are inevitable. This happened as Jiang Li was moving forward. A group of young men suddenly blocked his way to mock him. The leader, Yan Tu, with a muscular build, sneered. "So, what advanced profession are you planning to awaken today?" Jiang Li knew this guy was also known as Yan Cao of Jincheng, the son of a powerful golden profession holder. He was one of the three geniuses of Jincheng Academy but was always overshadowed by Jiang Li at school. So, Jiang Li ignored him and walked past. But Yan Tu wasn't going to let it slide. He grabbed Jiang Li's shoulder and taunted, "Don't be so arrogant. Be careful you don't awaken a low-level profession. Then don't blame us for not saving your face." Jiang Li's demeanor changed immediately. He no longer kept his calm attitude and demanded that Yan Tu let go. At first, Yan Tu was furious and glared at him. In that moment, he saw a deadly threat in Jiang Li's sharp eyes, which seemed to kill in an instant. Anger boiled inside him, but he swallowed it. Jiang Li had anticipated all of this. He knew he would be the center of attention today. If he failed to awaken, humiliation would be inevitable. It's the way of life. When a genius fails, they become a laughingstock. Later in the stands, everyone gathered to watch the other students awaken. The first one was Zhang Danyu from Class 1, who failed to awaken. He left the stands dejected and disappointed. The girl holding the list on the stage encouraged her classmates not to be disheartened if they awakened common professions. She said that effort and potential were just as important. The next person stepped up, and a bright blue flame blazed from the awakening machine, drawing everyone's attention. The girl with golden hair, bright blue eyes, and holding a huge bow had just successfully awakened to a high-level profession. The Gale Archer. The crowd below cheered and clapped from Yuan Li, the genius girl of Jincheng Academy. She glanced down and saw Zhang Li clapping for her. Moments later, another wave of cheers erupted as another high-level profession appeared. This time, it was Yan Tu from Class 3, who had successfully awakened as a flame mage. He clicked his tongue in regret, feeling that his awakening was just average. Students whispered among themselves about the appearance of two high-level professions. They thought Class 1 might be strong, but the best was yet to come. They were referring to Jiang Li. To save face, Yan Tu mocked him, saying they were inexperienced to get excited over every high-level profession. He didn't forget to taunt Jiang Li, saying, "Don't think that working hard like a clown will change anything. This kind of talent is inborn." Jiang Li didn't bother to respond, thinking of him as an idiot. When he heard his name called, he ran up to the stage. When the other teachers heard the name Jiang Li, they immediately showed a very positive attitude. After all, he was the best student in the school, handsome, polite, and the one everyone was looking forward to. As he stepped onto the stage, a beam of light began to move around him. Books and weapons floated in the air to harmonize their power with him. The academy's teacher suddenly stood up in surprise. What appeared was something unexpected. An anomaly, he suspected it might be the only hidden profession. But to everyone's shock, when the power settled, the announcement showed that Jiang Li had only awakened a common mage profession. All the teachers expressed their disappointment. The old man with silver hair next to him asked, "Wasn't he supposed to be the best student?" The teacher was just as confused, standing there with a blank mind. Seizing the moment, Yan Tu laughed heartily, mocking Jiang Li, saying he was not even as good as his flame mage. At that moment, everyone swarmed around Mu Yuan Li, showering her with compliments. Both boys and girls praised her endlessly. Zhang Li fell into deep thought, his face completely changed. His emotions plummeted to the extreme, as if his world had collapsed. The same people who had praised him to the skies now turned against him, hurling insults and mockery. They ridiculed him for being the top student yet only a mage, saying their high expectations were wasted. One by one, they spoke ill of him right in front of his face. Zhang Li found himself completely alone, without a single person to defend him. Zhang Li couldn't believe what was happening. Was he really that useless? Just as he was falling into the depths of despair, the system screen displayed that he had awakened a special talent, max level skills. Zhang Li was shocked by this announcement. He had never heard of such an item and wondered if it had anything to do with his time travel. He stared at the three blue columns, and suddenly they started to level up uncontrollably until they reached the maximum level. He remembered his teacher's words. After awakening, each profession starts with 3 level 1 skills. As these skills level up, power and proficiency increase dramatically. But upgrading skills is extremely difficult. No one had ever maxed out their skills before. But now with Zhang Li, it was possible. He grinned widely, realizing how simple maxing out skills was. He felt elated, thinking fate had finally favored him. This auto-max level skill was even more powerful than a hidden profession. Lost in his thoughts, he suddenly heard his teacher calling his name repeatedly. The teacher wanted to encourage him, saying that although his profession wasn't special now, at least he had become a professional. The future held many opportunities, and the teachers still believed in him. Zhang Li forced a smile, accepted the encouragement, and thanked his teacher. The principal, seeing his good mood, told him to return to class. Everyone thought he wasn't upset, but no one knew about his new abilities. He walked down the stage, head down, pretending to be devastated to put on a show for the students. People are more interested in watching a genius fail than succeed. Too bad for them. They were in for a disappointment. At this moment, everyone was practicing shooting. The red-haired guy, feeling confident after his recent success, shot a fireball that hit the target dead center. The young men around him clapped and cheered. Just when he saw Jiang Li, he called him over to taunt him. Annoyed when Jiang Li ignored him, he used fire to block his way. Zhang Li turned around, frowned, and asked, "What do you want?" The red-haired guy pointed to a distant dummy and demanded Zhang Li shoot at it. Zhang Li shook his head and refused without hesitation. "You guys practice on your own. I don't need to." The red-haired guy got furious, his face turning red with anger. He accused Zhang Li of being a coward, too afraid to compete with a high-level flame mage like him. He demanded Zhang Li show his skills. Having had enough, Zhang Li decided to teach him a lesson. He clicked his tongue and shot 3 fireballs. The red-haired guy sneered, thinking it was just a common fireball spell. But a second later, there was a massive explosion behind them, and everyone ran away in fear. He turned around confused by the noise. When he looked back, he saw all the targets were hit perfectly. He couldn't believe his eyes. Could a common mage really be this powerful? But Zhang Li didn't care. He walked away thinking that the power of max-level fireballs didn't need to follow the usual rules. Zhang Li went home, thinking that although the max-level fireball was powerful, it used up nearly half of his mana. He realized he needed to level up quickly to increase his mana limit. Lost in thought, he was greeted by his cheerful mother as soon as he entered the house. His mother, Qing Xu, was holding a plate of steaming hot food and told him to wash his hands for dinner. During the meal, he told his mother that he had successfully awakened as a mage. Qing Xu was overjoyed. To her, being a mage was great because they could safely release skills from the backlines in the army. Seizing the moment, she got up to retrieve something for him. She brought out a box left by his father, saying that his father had also been a very strong professional. Hearing this, Zhang Li was shocked. He clearly remembered his mother telling him that his father had died when he was born. He jumped up and started asking a bunch of questions. Where did his father go if he was such a powerful professional, and why hadn't he contacted them all these years? Qing Xu looked visibly pained, as mentioning his father brought back an unbearable sorrow. She explained that she didn't know either. Before his father left, he had told her that he needed to go to the world's border for urgent matters. He left in a hurry. She asked Zhang Li not to blame his father. His father wanted him to become a mage, which is why she had always guided him toward that path. But Zhang Li felt uncomfortable with this. He frowned and looked away. Sensing his discomfort, Qing Xu started to cry. She then went to her room to rest, reminding him to check the box's contents. Feeling awkward and silent, Zhang Li hesitated for a long time before finally opening the box. A golden light shone from the box, illuminating the entire room. Inside, there was a note that read, "Using this scroll can change your profession to a powerful archmage. The condition for the change is having the strength of a golden level mage or higher." He was stunned, sweating, and dizzy. He never thought there was a hidden profession that could transition to such a special and powerful one, achieving the golden professional level. In this world, The professional system has a clear hierarchy. When someone reaches a certain level and meets the corresponding conditions, they can break through to a higher level. Yantu's father is one of the top professionals in Jincheng, but even he is only at the golden level. Now, with this hidden scroll, Zhang Li wondered what level his father had reached. Was he a saint, or even a demigod? More importantly, if his father had such power, why had he been missing for so many years? Closing the box, Zhang Li decided that his immediate priority was to level up to a golden level professional. The trial would begin in 7 days. All the professionals of his generation would participate, so he had to prepare. The day finally arrived. As soon as people saw him, they started talking. Some mocked him for being an ignorant kid looking for trouble just after awakening. Others sarcastically suggested that maybe he was secretly a powerful professional. One guy laughed, saying that Zhang Li's small, weak frame couldn't accomplish anything. Seeing the ridicule, an older girl couldn't stand it. She approached Zhang Li, patted him on the shoulder, and asked if he wanted to join her team since he looked like a newbie. Her companions immediately dismissed the idea, saying they had important tasks and couldn't afford any distractions. Another guy agreed, saying that it wasn't their problem if Zhang Li didn't know his limits, and told Vivi to stay out of it. Vivi was furious. Zhang Li appreciated her good intentions but wanted to go alone to avoid any trouble. As he hurried away, the girl stopped him and handed him a potion. She said, "Even if you don't want to team up with us, at least take this. You look like a mage, so it might come in handy later." Zhang Li thanked her for her kindness. Vivi smiled and wished him well. Zhang Li then entered the gloomy forest. As soon as he entered, he encountered a level 4 goblin. He stood behind a tree observing. Taking aim, he threw a fireball at the unsuspecting goblin. The goblin turned around just as the fireball hit it square in the face. The power of the max level fireball spell was immense. One hit was enough to take down the large level 4 goblin. But before Zhang Li could celebrate, he noticed unusual movements. A swarm of goblins appeared above him, staring at him with fierce eyes, ready to tear him apart. The noise he had made had attracted them, and they were armed and ready to fight. They charged at him in a pack. Zhang Li quickly used a defensive spell, thinking it was easier to deal with them all at once rather than individually. First, he cast the max level light armor spell. When the goblins attacked with their sticks, they couldn't break through. Several attacked him at once, but the max level light armor was incredibly strong and not easily broken. This gave him enough time for his fireball spell to cool down. He immediately attacked from the ground. The powerful blast wiped out the goblin horde in an instant. It was like using a sledgehammer to kill a fly. Unfortunately, the experience gained was minimal, only enough to level up twice. Just then, one goblin remained behind him. Zhang Li smirked, ready to snap his fingers to finish it off. He thought that no matter how many came, the result would be the same. But as he snapped his fingers, the fire fizzled out. It turned out that Zhang Li had completely run out of mana. Using two fireball spells and one light armor spell had drained him. The little mana he had left was from leveling up. Fortunately, his light armor still had some energy left. He decided to use the meditation technique to restore his mana after dealing with the remaining goblins. While waiting for his mana to recover, he couldn't break their defenses. So, he grabbed a wooden stick and decided to fight them head-on. He wanted to show them the melee power of a mage. Sadly, the melee damage of a mage was very low. Even so, 10 points of damage were enough to shut them up. He fought until he was exhausted, finally finishing them off by nightfall. The physical damage of a mage was truly too low, but his skill level increased again. Zhang Li checked his skills. His attack magic included the fireball spell, which he could use twice with his current mana. While waiting for the fireball spell to cool down, he would need to use light armor. Feeling frustrated, he realized this method was not efficient at all. In the dark forest, with rustling sounds and birds flying everywhere, danger loomed again. Before he could prepare, a massive elite monster appeared. It was 4 times the size of a normal goblin, wielding a sharp sickle, and had a muscular body. Zhang Li was concerned. On the one hand, defeating an elite monster would give him a lot of experience. On the other hand, he wasn't sure if he could win. To test the situation, Zhang Li used light armor. Sadly, nothing happened. The elite monster looked at him in confusion. Unfortunately, he didn't have enough mana for the light armor spell. This time, he was truly in trouble. The monster took advantage and swung its axe, aiming for Zhang Li's head. He quickly jumped to the side, dodging the blow that smashed into the stone ground, shattering it. At this moment, Zhang Li felt truly frustrated. Trouble always seemed to come at the worst times. Just as he dodged one danger, another goblin hit him hard on the back. Zhang Li ran forward, realizing they were bullying him because he was out of mana. As he ran, he thought about his options. One plan was to find an opportunity to use the meditation technique to recover his mana, but in this chaotic situation, there was no time to focus. While running, he had to dodge the rocks the goblins were throwing. The second option was to use the only potion he had. This ordinary potion would only restore about a third of his mana. It wouldn't be enough for the fireball spell, but it would be enough for the light armor spell. The third option was to keep running, recover his strength, and come back to fight later. Of course, Zhang Li wasn't a coward who would run away. That wasn't his style. If he waited for his mana to recover naturally, it would take 24 hours. By then, someone else might defeat the elite monster. Determined, he quickly opened the potion bottle and drank it all in one gulp. His mana surged rapidly, enough to power up his shield. Just as he finished drinking, the elite monster swung its club at him again. It smashed down with all its might, but this time the shield didn't break. Only the ground shattered. Zhang Li glanced at his mana gauge, wondering how much he could recover before the max level light armor spell broke. Deciding to take a risk, he sat down and began to focus his mind. The monster, feeling insulted, flew into a rage. Its eyes turned red and it bared its teeth, hitting his shield furiously. Zhang Li remained still, concentrating. Finally, after a frenzied assault, the monster broke through the shield, but by then Zhang Li had fully recovered his mana. He smirked, tired yet. Now it's my turn. As the monster paused, confused, Zhang Li snapped his fingers, sending a fireball straight at its face. The explosion blasted it backward, hitting all the smaller goblins behind it. They were all taken out by the powerful blast. He successfully attacked the weak point, causing a critical hit. Although this method was risky, the max-level meditation technique was truly amazing. With one hit, his experience increased by 4 levels. It was incredible. Zhang Li approached the monster's body to see if it had any good items. He found a pair of agile gloves and a fine leather armor, both of black iron level. However, given the intensity of the battle, if he hadn't killed the monster, it would have killed him. These beginner-level items wouldn't be much help in the long run. He decided to keep them to sell later, tucking them into his bag with a click of his tongue. He also realized that with his current mana, he couldn't cast 3 fireball spells in a row. Each time, he had to risk his life to gather the monsters, which was exhausting. This efficiency was terrible. Killing regular monsters all day wasn't as effective as killing one elite monster. Frustrated, he rubbed his chin, wishing for a large-scale attack spell. Suddenly, he noticed a skill book among the items. This was exactly what he needed, and it was a skill that even a novice professional could learn. As he opened the book, a surge of power hit him. The first skill he saw was Arc Lightning, a ranged attack with paralysis and damage effects. It was perfect. Zhang Li smiled broadly, looking satisfied. This was a skill that could grow and had very good effects. Meanwhile, the goblins were camping in the forest. Some were sleeping while others stood guard. A sudden electric wave hit them, jolting them awake. Zhang Li was testing his new skill, but it didn't finish them all off. Determined, he cast it again, and this time, it wiped them out. The damage wasn't as high as the fireball spell, but 4 arc lightning casts used up about the same mana as 2 fireball spells. Not to mention, the casting and cooldown times were shorter than the fireball spell, and it didn't require concentration. This was exactly what he had been looking for. Reflecting on it, he realized how useful this skill was. Now he needed a strategy to eliminate the smaller monsters before targeting the next area, the boss zone in the gloomy forest. An elite monster had given him many rewards and experience, so the boss area would surely offer even more. Thinking of this, he grinned as if he had found treasure. But before going after the boss, Zhang Li sat down to recover his mana and plan his next move. As Zhang Li ventured deeper into the forest, he approached the goblin tribe. In front of the fire stood a stone goblin dressed in ceremonial robes, resembling a master. The boss area was likely inside. He looked around and saw that the entire group was asleep. Smiling, he tiptoed quietly, planning to sneak in and find the boss, then hit it with 2 fireball spells. Unfortunately, he stepped on a broken branch, making a noise that woke one goblin. Zhang Li rushed forward and hit it on the head with his stick, but it didn't die. Instead, it just got a bump on its head and started screaming, waking the others. Zhang Li quickly ran forward, apologizing, "Don't chase me. I'm sorry. I just want to fight the boss." Goblins started throwing rocks at him. Angered, Zhang Li rubbed his sore spot. "Fine. If you won't take the easy way, then you'll face the consequences." He used Arc Lightning to take them all out in quick succession. Their health dropped steadily until they were dead. After finishing them off, he dusted off his hands. Looking around, he found it strange that the boss was nowhere to be seen. He thought maybe it wasn't in the tribe. Suddenly, the ground began to crack. Zhang Li panicked, thinking it was an earthquake. He didn't notice the statue of the goblin starting to glow above him. Meanwhile, 3 young men were walking together in the forest. Yantu, Zhang Li's rival, was scheming to get rid of him, hoping to please his uncle. He wondered what kind of reward he would receive. One of his companions questioned if Zhang Li was still alive in the forest. Yantu glared at him and said, "Don't you trust me?" The other guy, scared, quickly shook his head, clarifying that it wasn't about doubting him. He was just worried that it was dangerous at night. If they encountered an elite monster or a boss, a novice professional wouldn't stand a chance. The earthquake also affected their area, and Yantu realized that someone had triggered the boss zone. This was an unexpected opportunity. He ordered, "This boss area is the goblin's ceremonial site. With 3 black iron professionals, we can handle it. It doesn't matter who is fighting the boss now, let them wear it down, and then we'll swoop in." Meanwhile, Zhang Li was still confused. Unsure if the creature was the boss of the gloomy forest or not, he didn't know if it was as strong as an elite monster. At this moment, the goblin priest reached level 20. It transformed into a true goblin, speaking in an ancient, strange language, with ice magic suddenly appearing in its hands. Zhang Li smirked and snapped his fingers, casting a fireball spell, not realizing the goblin was also a mage. He cast his spell before the goblin could attack. The fireball hit its weak spot, but the goblin didn't die. Instead, it launched an ice shard at him at an even faster speed. Luckily, Zhang Li managed to block it with his shield, but the damage was too high. One hit almost drained his entire mana pool. The goblin used its cloak to shield itself from the flames. When the fire dissipated, it was ready to attack again, but was surprised to find Zhang Li had vanished. The goblin realized what had happened and shot an ice ball, smashing the tree in front of it. Zhang Li, hiding behind the next tree, was terrified. His heart pounded as he realized that while he had hit the goblin's weak spot, its cloak likely had fire resistance and magic defense properties. He thought about the goblin's cloak and its protective abilities. He knew he couldn't defeat the boss with his current mana. The only option was to recover some mana while the goblin was still unaware of his exact location. The goblin began destroying the surrounding trees in search of him. Soon, only one large tree stood between them. The goblin shot a blast that hit the tree where Zhang Li was hiding. At the moment, they faced each other directly. The goblin grinned wickedly, using its magic to suspend huge ice chunks above Zhang Li's head, ready to drop them at any moment. But his mana gauge still showed that he didn't have enough for a fireball spell. His last option was to take a risky chance. Zhang Li quickly used arc lightning to block the falling ice chunks. The continuous lightning strikes paralyzed the goblin, causing it to lower its guard. Seizing the moment, Zhang Li lunged forward and grabbed the goblin's cloak. "Without this, you can't block my magic, right?" Step 1 was to confiscate its gear, and step 2 was to attack from behind. Zhang Li moved behind the goblin, jumped up, and kicked it. It took a moment for the goblin to get back on its feet. Now, it was utterly furious. Its eyes glowed blood red as it searched for Zhang Li. When it looked up and saw a fluttering cloak, it sneered, thinking it had located him. It used ice magic to attack the tree. 3 blasts created a massive explosion. It kept firing continuously, confident that it had defeated him, but when the attack ceased, it realized there was nothing there. Suddenly, Zhang Li's voice came from behind, laughing, "Where are you looking? The game is over." The goblin turned around instinctively. Before it could react, a fireball hit its face. Though it tried to create a shield with its staff, it was useless against Zhang Li's spell. As expected, Zhang Li delivered a critical hit. Zhang Li was pleased with his clever plan. The goblin had defensive skills, but he had a max-level fireball spell. Without fire resistance, its defenses were useless. He concluded that the goblin was unlucky to encounter him. Picking up a wooden stick nearby, Zhang Li delivered a final blow to the goblin's head, sending it to its demise. This victory boosted his experience significantly, and he found several useful staves. Unfortunately, the fire-resistant cloak was now damaged and unusable. Zhang Li opened another skill book and learned a powerful level 5 ice arrow spell. He was curious to see how strong it would be at max level. He also grabbed a bronze staff with piercing damage, which explained why his light armor spell was easily broken. With this new staff, he could now effectively deal with magic-resistant creatures. Just as Zhang Li was about to rest, trouble found him again. The group of young men who had been waiting earlier finally approached him, intending to block his way. Seeing Zhang Li alone, one of them guessed that his team had been wiped out. Qiwen took one look and said, "So, you're Zhang Li. You awakened as a professional and dared to enter the boss area alone. Not bad. The team you abandoned was probably stronger than you." Zhang Li found this strange and wondered how they knew his name. Qiwen confidently introduced himself as a member of the NGM family from Jinqin, and asked if Zhang Li had bullied his cousin. Zhang Li didn't want any trouble and shook his head, denying the accusation. He explained that his cousin was a genius student at the academy, and no one would dare bully him, especially with his older brother around. Zhang Li then suggested they could be friends and offered some small items. But Qiwen sneered, saying he wanted to beat Zhang Li up, not befriend him. Seeing this, Zhang Li dropped the pretense and prepared for a fight. He thought to himself that if they insisted on fighting, he had no choice. One of the guys with glasses shouted, warning that Zhang Li was using a meditation technique to restore his mana. Qiwen laughed, dismissing the importance of mana restoration. He boasted that 3 black iron professionals could easily defeat a novice, especially a common mage. By then, Zhang Li had almost fully recovered. A smile spread across his face, and his eyes sharpened. Knowing they were Black Iron professionals was excellent. Qian pointed at him and said, "Do you really think you can fight us to the death? Let me tell you, we won't give you a chance to cast any spells." Before he could finish his sentence, Zhang Li unleashed an arc lightning spell, electrocuting them and sending them flying. As expected, Qian and his gang were left beaten and lying on the ground. Zhang Li looked at them arrogantly, his eyes filled with disdain. He taunted them, "Everyone says villains die early because they talk too much. I'm waiting for my mana to recover. What are you waiting for?" Qian, his face battered, stubbornly asked how Zhang Li could cast spells so quickly. Zhang Li smirked and cast another fireball, burning all their clothes. The group lay there like helpless children. After dealing with them, Zhang Li looted the valuable items from their bodies. After all, they were Black Iron professionals. It was more profitable to take their gear than to fight monsters. Grinning, he put away the loot. Then he started planning his next move. He had just finished the boss area and gained 3 levels. Tomorrow, he would need a different approach. 3 Black Iron professionals had been defeated by a novice mage. Zhang Li crawled into Mai Kuai town, exhausted. By the time he arrived, he was spent. His vision blurred, his legs trembled, and he was drenched in sweat, leaning heavily on his staff. The heavy load of items he carried made him feel dizzy. He wished he had a spatial storage item. He approached a shop called Golden Dragon Treasure Pavilion, which was filled with various materials. Despite the late hour, it was still bustling. A girl in a bunny outfit politely asked if she could help him. He immediately opened his bag and dumped out all the materials he wanted to sell. She stared at the mess in silence, then politely said she would tally it up. After a while, she told him that the total market value of his items was 972,000 dragon scales coins. She would round it up to 1 million dragon scales coins for him. Zhang Li was stunned, his jaw dropping and eyes widening in shock. He couldn't speak. His mother only made 3 to 4 thousand a month, and here he was, making 1 million as easily as turning his hand. This must be the difference between a professional and an ordinary person. If he continued like this, he and his mother would have a good life. Inspired, he asked the clerk if they sold basic skill books. She nodded. At that moment, a girl with purple hair who had been watching Zhang Li stepped forward. The clerk presented a variety of advanced skill books for Zhang Li to choose from, including delay spell, summoning spell, ice arrow spell, and many others, each costing 600,000 dragon scales coins. Seeing the prices, Zhang Li sighed deeply. 1 million coins didn't seem like much after all. He decided to focus on low-level skills for now. He needed to master Fireball, Arc Lightning, and Ice Arrow. Both single and combo moves were essential, along with the defensive light armor spell. Although Arc Lightning had a paralysis effect, its duration was too short. After careful consideration, he gritted his teeth and bought a control skill book. With the remaining money, Zhang Li decided to solve his mana issues by buying supplements. He asked the clerk if they sold mana potions. Meanwhile, in the reception area, a girl sat across from an old man. The old man cautiously shared information about a hidden dungeon appearing in the Gale Plains. The entrance hadn't been found yet, and more time was needed. Miss Mo crossed her legs, her face elegant and confident. She smiled and said it was fine. As long as they found the entrance, she would send people to search for it tomorrow. She thanked Manager Lin. Although they were discussing business, her thoughts lingered on Zhang Li. She'd had heard rumors about his troubled awakening ceremony, which supposedly left him as an ordinary mage. He shouldn't be here, and she wondered if she had mistaken him for someone else. Lost in thought, the old manager's cough brought her back to reality. She shook her head, embarrassed to admit her distraction. The old manager calmly stated that if she could conquer the hidden dungeon, her level would surely rise quickly, reaching the Black Iron rank without any problem. By the next week's competition, she would definitely be able to overpower Miss Li by 1 level. She responded vaguely, telling Uncle Fu to summon the Mo group immediately because there was no time to waste. They needed to enter the hidden dungeon promptly. Soon Zhang Li arrived at the Gale Plains. He encountered some monster wolves charging at him, using arc lightning. He managed to bring them to half health. With his increased level, his magic damage had also risen. Now, fighting goblins was easy. One hit with arc lightning could kill them instantly. Lost in thought, he was surprised by a monster attacking from behind. Luckily, his shield was up, and it recoiled in pain. Frustrated, Zhang Li realized dealing with them one by one would take too long. He decided to speed up, leading them to chase him. He then quickly turned and cast arc lightning, hitting the group. However, one or two wolves managed to dodge the attack. Zhang Li noticed this but remained confident that they would eventually fall. Zhang Li used his staff to cast a max-level delay spell. The release was quick, without any casting trace, and it couldn't be dodged. However, it could only target one creature at a time, making it a bit extravagant to use 3 times. Taking advantage of this, he quickly took down the group of monsters. After the battle, he calmly drank some mana potions he had bought from the Golden Dragon Treasure Pavilion, significantly increasing his efficiency today. Drinking and chuckling to himself, he felt quite pleased. Just as he was laughing, he turned around and suddenly faced disaster. The level 20 Bloodmark Dire Wolf had been lurking. It was fiercer and more powerful than any other creature he had encountered. Zhang Li hid behind some rocks, spying on the Dire Wolf from above. Suddenly, he launched a surprise attack using Arc Lightning to strike from above. While the wolves were paralyzed, he quickly jumped down, aiming to take out the alpha. He fired a fireball straight at the boss, which also killed the smaller wolves nearby. Now, it was a one-on-one fight. The dire wolf, enraged and in pain, charged at him. Its sharp eyes and fierce attacks were met with Yang Li's max-level delay spell, freezing it in place. The beast growled at him, but couldn't move. Zhang Li calmly approached, saying, "I may not know the exact weak spot of the Gale Wolf, but one thing is certain: a fur-covered creature like you must fear fire." His words were firm and confident. The monster shivered in fear, meeting the same fate as its pack. This victory increased Zhang Li's experience level once again. This time, he found a black iron ring and a black iron dagger. Though they were black iron equipment, their small size made them easy to carry. Excited, Zhang Li rummaged through the loot for more items. Suddenly, the ground began to shake strangely. Looking up, he saw an entire pack of wolves charging toward him like a flood. Feeling a bit uneasy, he quickly opened a mana potion, ready for battle. He couldn't believe that killing one elite wolf had brought the whole pack for revenge. As they rushed at him, he braced himself, only to find that they swept past him like the wind, ignoring him completely. Zhang Li broke into a cold sweat, his face pale. He was about to breathe a sigh of relief, thinking the wolves weren't coming for him. Then he realized his mistake: wolves are pack animals. If they gathered in such numbers, it could only mean the Wolf King had been provoked. Understanding this, he quickly gathered his things and dashed after the wolf pack. He couldn't let someone else steal the prize so easily. At the boss area, things were chaotic. Two groups were fighting for control. A bald man yelled at his opponents, accusing them of taking advantage of the situation. "You think you're heroes?" he shouted as his companion was hit, an arrow piercing his heart. This was the group with Vivi, who had earlier invited Zhang Li to join them. Now they were under attack. The attacking group was arrogant, clearly not heroes, but they thought the others were fools. They were trying to defeat the boss without proper preparation, making them easy targets for a robbery. The leader of the attackers was a red-haired man, and his gang had many members. They intended to steal both the loot and the blood-marked Wolf King. The bald man agreed to surrender as long as they let his group go. But they sneered, demanding their priestess, the girl from their group. Their leader revealed his vile, lecherous nature. The supposed heroic captain turned out to be a coward, abandoning his comrades and fleeing. It seemed like the end for them. Suddenly, Zhang Li appeared like a savior. He immediately used Arc Lightning to ambush the attackers. The red-haired leader was furious, squinting to see who dared to ruin his plans. Zhang Li emerged from the flames, his voice deep and his demeanor elegant. "It's not even dark yet, and you're already out here robbing people. Such dedication," he mocked. One of the red-haired leader's underlings tried to ambush Zhang Li from behind. However, he was swiftly knocked back. Vivi was startled to see that their savior was the young man she had met earlier. The red-haired leader grew more cautious, gripping his sword defensively. He didn't care about his comrades at this point. Seeing Zhang Li take down several of his men with one move, he realized Zhang Li was no ordinary mage. Underestimating him was a mistake. He ordered all his remaining men to attack at once. Zhang Li sighed, finding it all too tedious. With a swift gesture, he cast a fireball spell, scattering the group. The red-haired leader was terrified, crying out in disbelief, "This can't be. How can a normal mage have such powerful attacks?" Desperate to save his own life, he fell to his knees, begging for mercy. He agreed to let Zhang Li take the girl, revealing that the blood-marked Wolf King was in the cave. The more Zhang Li listened, the more annoyed he became. He cast an ice arrow spell, shooting an arrow straight into the leader's head. The leader spat blood, uttering his last words, "The Blood Wolf mercenaries will not forgive you." In a flash, Zhang Li had dealt with the situation swiftly and efficiently. Zhang Li enthusiastically searched through the loot, feeling exhilarated by his newfound ability to use multiple skills in quick succession. The benefits of leveling up were clearly significant, and this thought alone made him quite happy. Vivi, standing nearby, hesitated for a moment before shyly stepping forward to thank him. She hadn't expected him to be so powerful, having previously worried that he might not be able to keep up. Zhang Li laughed it off, reminding her that she had saved him once before, so now they were even. Seeing that her team was no longer around, Zhang Li invited her to join him in fighting the boss. Vivi watched him intently, surprised by his confidence. Just moments ago, he had taken down a gang of thugs, and now he wanted to take on a boss. Despite his young age, his abilities were remarkable. She wondered if he was hiding some incredible talent, but couldn't figure out why he was so strong. Boss, a level 25 bloodmarked Wolf King, was sleeping inside. Vivi, knowing she was only level 20 and had just reached the Black Iron rank, looked at Zhang Li with concern, wondering if the two of them could handle it. And unexpectedly, Zhang Li charged forward and threw a fireball at the boss. The monster immediately woke up, leaping high into the air and lunging at Zhang Li. He quickly retreated, using his shield to block the attack. The boss's powerful strike almost shattered his shield, despite being slowed down by the delay spell. The wolf was still incredibly agile. Realizing he needed to get serious, Zhang Li decided to fight with full focus. Vivi would support with magical attacks. Zhang Li cast the ice arrow spell at its highest level, but the monster dodged skillfully. Suddenly, a pack of wolves, the ones Zhang Li had seen outside, charged in. The boss was summoning minions. Vivi warned Zhang Li to be careful while she continued to supply mana. Zhang Li, undeterred, charged into the enemy den alone, quickly dispatching the smaller wolves and gaining experience rapidly. He didn't expect the cave to be so small. Summoning so many minions actually limited the Gale Wolf King's agility. Thinking this, he boldly challenged the monster. Once again, minions appeared at the Wolf King's feet, growling and baring their fangs with blood-red eyes. Zhang Li smiled. This was exactly what he wanted. He lunged forward, ready to deal with all of them at once. Zhang Li quickly dealt with the pack of wolves, so efficiently that Vivi started to feel sleepy with nothing to do. Killing those small wolves significantly boosted his experience points. After each round, he drank potions to replenish his strength. Finally, only the boss remained. Zhang Li aimed his bow, ready to shoot at any moment. Monster, now exhausted and battered, sounded like an old man, its voice trembling as it admitted it had no strength left. Zhang Li, a bit disappointed, remarked that it didn't last long enough. With no other choice, he decided to end it swiftly and took the last bit of its health. The Wolf King, with tears in its eyes, called him a devil before dying. Vivi was surprised to find that she had also leveled up. Zhang Li explained that leveling up by 3 levels meant there would be a lot of loot, which could earn them a considerable amount of money. Vivi recalled watching him fight and was amazed that he used the boss's summoning skills to farm experience. She wondered who the real boss was. Suddenly, Zhang Li called Vivi over. She ran to him and saw that he was handing her a staff, saying it was her share. Vivi was surprised since she felt she hadn't done much. Zhang Li explained that she had helped him recover mana and boost his magic damage, making her a valuable support. He added that he would need her help again if they faced more dangers in the future. Vivi nodded eagerly, feeling a bit dreamy about how important she was to him. However, Zhang Li was already focused on his stats, thinking about the skill books he had picked up but hadn't examined yet. One was a lightweight technique that increased movement speed, explaining why the boss could still move normally despite being hit by his spells. The other was a swamp technique, which could control multiple enemies at once. Just then, Vivi called him over to show him something on the ground. It was Yulong grass. While it wasn't useful for professionals, it was a top-tier medicinal herb for ordinary people, capable of curing many illnesses. She suggested they could sell it for a good price. After dividing the herbs, Zhang Li accepted his share with a smile, thanking her. He thought about his mother who had worked hard all her life and suffered from various ailments. With this herb, he hoped to help her feel better. Vivi suddenly noticed a strange light emanating from behind a rock crevice. They both managed to crawl out. After hearing Zhang Li's suggestion, she agreed to continue stalling for him if they encountered danger. At this moment, the screen displayed the next mission: Stop the Dark Mage Garubi's ritual. Zhang Li quickly realized that defeating a Dark Mage could potentially drop valuable mage-related items. Without hesitation, he sped off like lightning with Vivi trailing behind. Suddenly, he stopped abruptly, causing her to nearly run into him. Gasping for breath, she asked why he had stopped. Zhang Li whispered that there was a skeletal knight ahead. This dungeon wasn't simple. Even the wild monsters were level 20. But he was determined to fight. A group of skeletal knights on horseback suddenly appeared from behind. They spoke human language and brandished weapons, charging at Zhang Li and Vivi, determined to attack the intruders. Zhang Li decided not to directly attack the skeletal knights, as their intelligence wasn't very high. Instead, he opted for an indirect approach. First, he cast a magic formation straight onto the ground, creating a powerful spell. The stones on the ground initially seemed normal, but suddenly the entire area became watery, resembling a lake. The skeletal knights stumbled, losing their balance and falling off their horses. Seizing the opportunity, Zhang Li swiftly threw a fireball, engulfing them in flames and burning them to ashes. It was evident that his high-level swamp spell covered a wide area. In the future, if he encountered a large enemy force, he wouldn't need to waste time dealing with each one individually. Suddenly, Zhang Li and Vivi heard a loud noise nearby. It seemed there were others in the vicinity. Indeed, on the other side, Mo King team was struggling. They were doing their utmost to protect the young lady inside. A skeletal knight lunged like an arrow, aiming directly at a soldier. Unexpectedly, Zhang Li dashed out of nowhere, using his shield to intercept the blow intended for him. The girl was momentarily surprised to see him. Upon hearing Zhang Li's name, the other person remembered he was the young lady's fellow classmate. What was strange was that he had only recently awakened. So he shouted, "Hey kid, these monsters aren't something a novice like you can handle. We can't guarantee your safety." Zhang Li just chuckled, launching another fireball that quickly incinerated the adversaries before him. Mo King, after this incident, began to see Zhang Li in a different light. He was truly impressive. The other guy, feeling his pride wounded, tried to justify himself by saying they could have handled it if Zhang Li hadn't interfered. But Mo King didn't seem to care and ran over to Zhang Li, smiling brightly. At first, Zhang Li didn't recognize her, but after a moment, he remembered she was the genius girl as famous as Li Moyuan. He reminded her that the difficulty of this dungeon was quite high and to be careful if she wanted to level up. Hearing this, the two behind her were embarrassed and angry. They were elite Black Iron professionals and felt insulted by his words. Zhang Li decided it was best to leave, feeling reassured that they wouldn't be able to steal his boss kill. Suddenly, Mo King called him back, asking if he hadn't reached the Black Iron level yet. After hesitating for a while and calculating something, he honestly replied that he was only level 17. Mo King was even more surprised. In just a few short days, Zhang Li had reached level 17. What kind of strength would it take to achieve that? To reach the Black Iron rank, one typically had to pass the Black Iron level trial or use a level-up gem. The latter was rare and expensive. Initially, Zhang Li hadn't planned on using that method, but at his current rate, he needed to reach level 12 before clearing the dungeon. Otherwise, any experience gained would be wasted without leveling up to Black Iron. The girl then suggested that Zhang Li could guide her through the dungeon. In return, she offered him a pendant, a valuable item. Zhang Li was stunned, staring at it intently. The girl, embarrassed, hugged herself and turned away, her face flushed. Zhang Li, not understanding why she was blushing, thought it over and agreed to let her join, excluding the two people behind her. He didn't want to share experience points with them. The two guards became even more furious. The blonde girl hurriedly tried to stop the young lady, urging her not to follow Zhang Li. She warned that if word got out, it would be a disgrace to their reputation as bodyguards. However, the young lady's stubborn nature prevailed, and she insisted they leave. Seeing her determination, one of the soldiers drew his sword and challenged Zhang Li, wanting to test his real strength and make him lose face. Unexpectedly, it was they who were humiliated. Zhang Li smirked, his hand already glowing with a fireball, showing no hesitation. Zhang Li's overwhelming power was far superior to that of the two soldiers. The fireball in his hand grew larger and larger. The soldier couldn't believe that a novice mage could create such a massive fireball. Now regretting his actions, he's ready to face the full brunt of the spell. However, Zhang Li, being kind-hearted, decided not to retaliate. He quickly dispelled the magic and allowed them to follow if they wished. The two soldiers, now terrified, paled and started flattering Zhang Li, calling him the strongest and assuring that clearing the dungeon wouldn't be a problem. Despite their words, they were relieved that Zhang Li didn't attack them, knowing they wouldn't have survived. They quickly retreated as per Mo King's orders. Mo King then asked Zhang Li if his previous awakening hadn't gone well. He confirmed that he was just an ordinary mage. As they continued forward, Vivi, frightened, pleaded with Zhang Li to include her in their future adventures. Zhang Li nodded in agreement. Seeing their closeness, Mo King felt a twinge of curiosity and jealousy. She introduced herself with a bright smile, saying, "My name is Mo King. May I ask what your name is?" Unable to stand their familiarity, she jumped next to Zhang Li. Mo King wondered how Zhang Li planned to handle the boss fight. With a confident smile, Zhang Li assured her that he had his ways. It didn't take long for Zhang Li to get an opportunity to showcase his abilities. He charged straight ahead, taking down the small monsters one after another. The two girls had to find a temporary hiding spot to avoid the chaos. Mo King was surprised by his reaction, while Vivi nodded in agreement, recalling her initial fear. What caught Mo King's attention was Zhang Li's immense power, which seemed unusual for a novice. Finally, the boss appeared. It was a level 27 skeleton commander, its body covered in a thick layer of dark energy. A monster suddenly attacked, catching Zhang Li off guard. It rammed into him, sending him flying into the wall behind. The two girls became its next targets. Realizing the urgency, Vivi stepped forward to shield Mo King. This act of bravery left Mo King even more impressed with Vivi. Suddenly, Zhang Li shot an ice arrow straight at the boss's head. Both girls turned in surprise. Zhang Li, staggering from the impact of the earlier blow, had small wounds on his face and body. Zhang Li felt a wave of relief as the lightweight technique hadn't worn off yet. Without it, his injuries would have been much worse. What he hadn't expected was that the monster could attack from a distance. Vivi quickly helped him recover mana as fast as possible. Mo King decided to assist as well, boosting Zhang Li's strength while weakening the enemy. Taking advantage of this, Zhang Li used his lightning arc technique to eliminate the enemies. The power of this attack was much greater than anything he'd used before. Vivi was astonished, finally realizing it was called Divine Light Blessing. Those with this ability could enhance the damage of their companions within close range, inflicting divine attribute damage. Additionally, enemies could be blinded and injured, and allies' strength would multiply several times over. This confirmed that the young lady's class was a holy priest, capable of increasing damage, making enemies vulnerable, and weakening them. The monster broke free from its paralysis. The three of them decided to team up to fight the boss. The creature charged at them, but Zhang Li was not afraid. On the contrary, he was excited knowing there was another dungeon ahead. No matter how many skeletal minions it summoned, they wouldn't stand a chance. At this moment, Mo King cast her blessing spell once again. The light from the spell blurred the monster's vision. When the light faded, the monster realized its enemies had vanished. As it looked up to search, it saw Zhang Li poised above, ready to strike. He waited for the perfect moment and then shot an arrow straight down, piercing the monster through the abdomen. The result was a brilliant victory. Zhang Li grabbed Mo King's hand and thanked her profusely, making her blush with embarrassment. After the battle, Zhang Li obtained a C-rank bone spear technique. However, his skill slots were full, so he had to switch it out. This technique was meant for black iron mages. While he was hesitating, Mo King suddenly handed him a glowing pearl. She said it was a reward in advance, explaining that she wanted him to become stronger to help with the dungeon so the experience points wouldn't be wasted. Shyly, she added in a much softer voice, "You can call me King King from now on." Zhang Li was overjoyed and didn't hesitate to start training. Suddenly, disaster struck as the dark mage appeared out of nowhere, catching them off guard. Outside the dungeon, the soldiers who had accompanied Ma King were getting scolded. One of them received a slap for letting the young lady enter alone. He timidly explained that while Zhang Li was a novice, he was very strong, so they should be okay. The steward, unaware of the situation, saw a red warning message appear, indicating danger. Realizing that they had entered the dungeon and encountered black iron level dark creatures, he immediately ordered the elite soldiers, all level 25 and below, to assemble and follow him for reinforcement. The sound of their footsteps was so loud that Vivi could hear it from a distance. Mo King guessed it was her troops, but she knew that if Zhang Li was interrupted while recovering his mana, he could explode. Just as the soldiers arrived, the dark mage sneered and attacked with a wooden staff. One soldier dodged and initially felt triumphant, thinking that even high-level monsters weren't much of a threat. Expectedly, a massive monster jumped from above and crushed him. The ground sank under its weight. As the group was at their wits' end, Zhang Li woke up. He stood up to fight, using his strength to shield them from another blow. This time, he used two spells simultaneously, having leveled up. "Come on, everyone, don't be so scared that you forget to fight back," he shouted. The steward, Uncle Fu, was skeptical. The monster was using bone spear technique, an abyssal demon ability. He doubted that a novice mage like Zhang Li could do much against it. Zhang Li shot several arrows at the monster's chest and arms. It laughed mockingly, but the wounds, though minor, left marks. Uncle Fu was astonished, unable to believe that someone like Zhang Li could injure it. Despite being a novice mage, he was proving effective. But the priority was Mo King's safety. With no other choice, they had to risk everything. Uncle Fu ordered everyone to attack simultaneously, determined to protect the young lady. He boosted his strength and entrusted Zhang Li with Mo King's safety. The monster, contemptuous, immediately launched a fireball attack. Uncle Fu gripped his sword tightly, his body exhausted and sweat pouring down his forehead. He continued to fight to the end, bracing himself to block the monster's attack. The force of the blow was immense. "Damn demon," he muttered. Summoning all his strength, he leapt up and unleashed his strongest move, the Judgment Slash. Even if he couldn't kill it, he had to buy time for the young lady. He was surprised the monster caught his sword as if it were a toy. It grabbed him and squeezed tightly, laughing cruelly and mocking his limited skill. Without any mercy, it threw him to the ground. Uncle Fu landed hard but quickly scrambled to his feet and ran to buy more time. He stumbled and fell but kept going. Mo King wanted to rush out to help, but Zhang Li held her back. As the monster closed in on Uncle Fu, ready to crush his bones, a single arrow struck its head. Enraged, it turned to see Zhang Li as the shooter. Immediately, it charged at him. Uncle Fu shouted for Zhang Li to run and leave the battle to them. But running away had never been Zhang Li's style. With a calm and determined expression, he aimed another arrow and broke one of the monster's wings. He had figured out how to weaken its strength. Uncle Fu was shocked to see that a mere black iron level mage could use two skills simultaneously, achieving maximum effect with their combination. The monster mocked them all, but it knew it was weakening. It grabbed the nearby mage, who was screaming and begging for mercy, and without hesitation, devoured him in front of everyone. This act restored the monster's strength and even boosted it. Now, the monster was furious, entering an extremely dangerous state. It roared angrily, releasing a massive wave of energy that swept through the area. Zhang Li quickly jumped aside to avoid the attack. This time, it was serious. The Lightfoot technique had saved him from death but left him unable to counterattack. Relying solely on the lightweight shield was pointless. Unexpectedly, Mo King once again used her blessing from a distance to enhance Zhang Li's attack power. His strength surged by 200%. The demon, now almost in a frenzy, prepared a fireball to wipe them all out. Zhang Li, acting quickly, increased his speed and dashed forward to shield his friends from the attack. This is the end. Please comment Zhang Li below if you want to do next part.